In this video, I'll cover the concept of negative externalities. By the end of this video, you will be able to explain what a negative externality is, and also be able to diagram a negative externality in consumption, and also in production. So what exactly is a negative externality? A negative externality occurs when a third party not involved in an economic transaction is harmed from that transaction. A common example for consumption is smoking, which I will explain further in the next few slides. Let's consider the case of negative consumption externalities. With negative consumption externalities, the social benefit equals the private benefit minus the external cost. I subtract external costs because we assume there are negative social benefits. Rather than add a negative benefit, I subtract the external cost. Let's break down what this means. The social benefit represents the benefit to society as a whole. The private benefit is the benefit received by the individual consuming the good or service. And the external costs, or the externality, are the cost to a third party not involved in the transaction. In the case of smoking, there is a negative externality to smoking in public places. Smokers sometimes enjoy their cigarettes in public without thinking of those affected who are around them. This could be other children or adults. This explains why, at least in the US and UK, smoking is banned in many public places and within all public buildings. Now let's look at the diagram. Costs and benefits are on the y-axis, output on the x. Our marginal private cost and marginal social cost are the same here because we assume there are no external costs in production. The marginal private benefit curve represents the benefit gained by the additional consumption of a good or service to the individual. The equilibrium price and output for this combination is P star and Q star. The free market would provide Q star quantity at a price of P star. If we factor in the costs imposed to individuals not involved in the transaction and subtract them from the marginal private benefit, we arrive at our marginal social benefit. This includes the cost to the individual and all third parties. You'll notice it is to the left of the marginal private benefit curve. The socially optimum level of output is QS at a price of PS. If the market was left to operate without any intervention, the result would be that this good would be overprovided when we consider the additional cost tied to the externality. Therefore, we say that there is a welfare loss or deadweight loss represented by triangle XYZ, which I will now display. To determine the welfare loss, we consider the points at which the marginal social benefit is less than the marginal social cost from our original equilibrium of P star Q star. Since the marginal social benefit at that point, Y, is less than the marginal social cost, X, less of this good should be produced. The welfare loss represents the sum of the cost of those additional units being consumed beyond the socially optimum level of output where marginal social benefit equals marginal social cost, or price PS and quantity QS. The welfare loss is represented by a triangle XYZ. Having an understanding of negative consumption externalities should help us understand negative production externalities. In the case of a negative production externality, the social cost of production is equal to the marginal private cost plus the marginal external costs. The supply curve shifts by the amount of the external cost. Assume that a factory is producing goods that require them to emit a certain amount of air pollution. The private costs to the factory owners include wages to employees, costs of materials, utilities, operating licenses, and rent. The external costs include the costs borne by third parties as a result of the pollution. That could involve pollution cleanup or medical expenses in treating air pollution-related illness. The social cost includes both the private cost of doing business and the cost to third parties of dealing with air pollution. The costs of production are a burden on both the producing firm and the uninvolved third party. Both parties have to dedicate resources to deal with the production levels of the firm, so therefore to achieve the socially optimal level, considering marginal social cost is a necessity. A negative production externality occurs when a third party faces a cost as a result of production process of another firm. Let's work through the diagram. We use the same axes as before. This time we assume that our marginal private benefit and marginal social benefit curves are the same. Next, we add in our marginal private cost. If left to the market, the production level would be Q star at a price of P star. However, the marginal social cost is greater than the marginal private cost due to the cost incurred by third parties that are harmed as a result of the production process. Thus, the socially optimum level of output, QS, is less than the free market allocation, Q star. The socially optimum price, PS, is higher than the free market price, P star. The welfare loss, or deadweight loss in this scenario, is represented by the triangle XYZ. We can see this by starting at our initial equilibrium point and noting that our marginal social cost, Y, is higher than the marginal social benefit, X, and therefore production should be reduced. If we continue this reduction until marginal social benefit equals marginal social cost, we'll note that the free market allocation leaves us with a deadweight loss of triangle XYZ. That wraps up this video on negative externalities. By now, you should be able to explain what a negative externality is and diagram both negative consumption and production externalities. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below or email me. Visit the website listed below and check out the additional resources available to help you study. For now, that's us done, and I will see you in the next one.